I like going in there with my clothes on because it keeps the heat, you know. It makes me sweat real faster, so therefore I only have to stay in for about 10 minutes. Instead of, if I have no clothes on, it takes maybe about 15, 20 minutes, you know. So I get it done a lot quicker with the clothes on. And besides, feel more comfortable with my clothes on. Take them off, it's time to, time for business. I'll drop my water maybe like 2 days out from a contest. Normally I would drink 2 gallons of water up to the day of the show. 2 days before the show, I'll drop down to 1 gallon. The night of the show, well, the night before the show, I'll only go like a half a gallon. And in turn, doing the sauna along with dropping your water intake will help you release the water underneath the skin so that you will look and appear a lot more defined when it comes to time for you to go on stage. A lot of competitors are sodium loading and sodium depleting and sodium loading. I think personally for me, when I prepare for a contest, I go on a strict diet. I do everything the same all the way up to the show. So therefore, a week out from the contest, I'm looking almost like I want to look the day of the show. I think that a lot of competitors, when they do certain things like this, they're really taking a chance. You know, it has been proven that the majority of the guys do have it down, but most of them, some of them, you know, are still experimenting. So I don't like to really experiment with anything. I like to go in a contest knowing that how I'm going to look 2 or 3 days out, you know. And just by dropping the water intake, I can maybe lose another 2 or 3 pounds if I have to by doing that.
Kevin, let's go, guys. Shoes on.
I'm wearing my socks.
Mentally, I've been prepared for as long as I can remember when I first started competing. When I go in the gym, I go in, I get the job done, I do what I have to do to look the way that I want to look for a contest coming up. And when you've trained so hard and you've lived this dream of competing in the Olympia and traveling around the world and all the good things that you can accomplished through the sport of bodybuilding, then it's very worthwhile to train hard and to diet hard for a day, especially as the Olympia. When you say you want to be a professional bodybuilder, when you put in your goal that you want to be a competitive bodybuilder, you have a challenge in which you are about to take on in life. You have to be positive. You have to have a mental drive, a focus, something that wants, you know, something in you to make you drive and want to excel. It's a very hard sport, but it's only hard if you give up.
Thank you.